want to say a hello, blessed new year to the pastors of Bible College, my friends. It's been a while. To the students, to the faculty, it's so nice to be back here.
所以呢，我也借这个机会要跟这些的老师们还有朋友们一起打招呼，很高兴能够再次的回到这里。
So today when I came, I wanted to meet with Daniel earlier.
哦，我来到这里呢，其实我是要与Daniel能够早一点的这样子的来见面。
Yeah, because I wanted to prepare for something for our devotion today.
哦，因为呢，我要预备就是给今天的这一个的灵修。
So I was sitting in the car park because I was early.
所以呢，我就到了这个的停车场。
And when I sat in the car park, I felt a flood of wonderful, precious memories of this entire place.
当我停在车的时候呢，哇，就有很多的这一些美好的回忆不断的涌流进来。
Because I was safe in glad tidings. Now it's called day one. The hall, what is it called now?
Main dining hall.
BCM Multipurpose Hall, right? So I was safe in BCM Multipurpose Hall.
所以呢，之前呢，我是在这一个的会堂那边睡觉的。
And my background is very complicated.
我的这个背景呢是蛮复杂的。
So for God to save me and for God to use me is really humbling.
让神能够来拯救和使用我，真的是一个非常谦卑的一个举动。
I grew up worshipping idols.
你知道我是成长长大是来敬拜这一些的偶像的。
And it's not just about going to temples and worshipping idols.
而不是说要去到哪里，然后去跟来敬拜这些的偶像。
At the age of 17, I actually was, I became a disciple to the 风水师傅。
17岁的时候呢，我就有和这个风水的这个师傅呢，成了他的这个的门徒。
For a period of 10 years, it went a deeper level because I was being trained to become a medium.
10年过后呢，我还被练成了另外一个的层次。
And being trained to become a medium was confusing because I am a Western educated lady.
因为呢，它也有一点的复杂，因为我是以一个西方的方式的成长环境。And
the history of growing up in idol worship.
还有就是带着一个历史背景是敬拜这个偶像的。I
didn't just go through one 师父.
我也经历了这个的一个师父。I
went through three 师父s.
我还不只是一个，而是三个师父。And
the third 师父 was a grand ceremony that we went through.
第三个师傅呢，他是有举办很大型的这一种的。
I remember it was like a tennis court, and then he's seated on the high chair.
我记得呢，在一个的球场那边，他坐在这个高凳。
And on the high chair, a declaration was made to the heavens.
这个的高凳呢，就是要来宣告呢，是给到这个的天堂的。
That this child,
这个孩子
belonged to the idol.
是属于那个偶像的。
That this child,
这个孩子
belong to the demon.
是属于那一个的。
So for me to stand here before you.
所以呢，让我能够站在这里你们面前。
And to say that I have been a minister of the Lord for 20 years.
我成为了来侍奉主已经20年了。
Not 2 years.
不是2年。
Not 10 years.
不是10年。
20 years.
20年。
Is nothing short of the love and the grace of God.
因着神的恩典。
Only the love and grace of God.
唯有神才能够。
So when I sat in the car park just now,
所以当我坐在这一个的停车场的时候,
好感动,
very touching,
very emotional.
Oh, 很感动.
Because I was saved here in the multi-purpose hall.
因为我就是在这个的地方被得救的.
Baptized,
被洗礼,
married.
结婚.
When we married, when I married at that time, I was in the youth ministry.
当我结婚的时候呢，那时我还在这个青少的这个事工.
So I met my husband in church lah. Glad tidings here as well. So I met my spouse there.
我在我的教会呢遇见了我的另一半.
And when I met him there, then relationship developed. We got married in the hall.
然后呢，当我遇到他，我们结婚的时候，我们也在这里结婚。
The whole hall filled with members of the church.
然后呢
，witness our wedding.
整个的会堂呢，就是充满了这个会友一起来见证这个的婚礼。
My children,
我的孩子
dedicated in this hall.
也是这样子的来侍奉。
When I became a licensed minister, the ceremony was in the hall.
也是同样的，很多的事情都是在这个大堂发生。
So you understand how I feel today?
你可以明白我今天的这个感受吗
？Today I'm not just coming here to share the word of God with you.
我今天不只是要来到和你分享这个神的话语。
Today I'm coming home to my roots.
现在呢，我要回到我的家。
This is where God raised me up.
这个就是神在所让我成长的一个地方。
This is where Godprepared me for the works of the ministry.
这个地方就是神预备装备我的地方。
This is not a historical place for me.
这个对我来说不是一个历史化的地方。
But today, I stand here knowing that God is still at work.
但是今天我站立，我知道神仍然掌权做事。
Amen.
Amen.
God is still at work in our lives.
神还是在我们的生命动工。
So just now in the introduction is like one long story, but I will tell you more later.
虽然呢，刚才那个介绍呢好像很长，但是等一下我会告诉你更多。
So before I go into the message that God laid in my heart today,
当我还没有进入这个的信息的时候
，I want to do a check-in with you.
我要来向你来有一个审查。
So my check-in with you is using Mentimeter.
就是呢，用这个 Mentimeter 的这个 apps.
Okay, so it's called Mentimeter, and I would like you to go to menti.com.And then key in the code 35371068 on your phones.
你可以进到这个 menti.com 呢，然后用这一个的code 35371068。
So if I were to ask you one by one, take a long time, lah, right?
当我要一个一个这样问呢，就花很长的时间。
So at least now everybody, you know, can participate. I would love to hear how has the past 2 years been for you.
我想要从你们那边听到呢，这两年你们是如何度过的
？But you can only describe it using two words.
但是你们只能够用两个字来表达。
Simple, not a problem.
简单不是问题。
But two separate words, yeah.
但是是两个分别不同的字。
If you are ready, yeah, just key in and the words will come out. This is called a word cloud.
然后呢，那个你当你一打下去的时候，那个字就会出来了。
I'd like to see what the last 2 years has been for you.
我们要来看看这两年对你们来说是什么样的一年。
Someone now says that it has been a time of awakening.
有人说是一个警醒的时刻。
Yet, it's calm.
也是一个很舒服的。
How about the rest?
其他人呢
？Tiring.
可以是很疲乏的。
I can understand it has been tiring for a lot, frustrating as well.
也是很困扰的。
Breaking, 华语不会讲。
It's joyful.
Yes.
And it's also fulfilling.
Fulfilling, wow, fantastic.
Contentment, yeah.
And some have gone through a breaking time. Others, it's been lonely.
有一些呢，也是来感觉到孤独。
Frustrated.It's been a time of breaking.
很困扰。
Anymore? Some feel called, and also it's been a time of equipping.
也是一个被神装备的一个季节。
Which are the new words?
Building.
Reset.
Reset.
That's right. I see the word reset.
重来。
And some pastors, I've heard them preach, and considered this time like a major reset by God.
我听了有一些的牧者，他们也觉得这一个的时间就是一个重新重整的一个时间。
It's been a time that is very fast paced, and also some have been using it to do building. Yes, change.
有一些很快，然后也是对用来建立的时间。
And yet found your rest in God.
而是我们怎样的在神里面得着这个的安息
？You see the, I see the word 怪，怪，
怪，
看到怪。
我看到这个很有能力的这个字。
Yeah, that. Oh, okay. I see some more words coming. Very good. New learning, depression, realization.
然后呢，要有新的学习。
You see the middle words that are getting bigger?
你有看到中间的这个字呢，变得越来越大吗？
The words that are getting bigger means more people are putting the same word.
就是很多人都说一样的东西。
So more of you here sense that this 2 years has been a time of breakthrough.
很多人呢，就觉得这两年呢，是一个的突破。
And yet a time of change.
也是一个转变改变的一个时间。
Every one of these experiences is unique and important.
每一个的这个的经历呢，是很特别的，也是很重要。
And God is doing something in our midst.
神确实在我们当中做事情。
My 2 words that I would put up.
我那两年两个字呢要放上去的就是
would be uncertainty.
就是不确定。
And wilderness.
还有就是旷野。
And I believe that the wilderness experience,
我相信呢，这个旷野的这个的经历呢，
is not just myself going through,
不是我一个人所经历的，
but it's a common experience that every one of us are going through together.
是一个每个人都会经历的。
Nationally,
无论是国度，
as a family,
身为一个家庭，
individually,
一个人。
We have gone into a time of wilderness.
我们都有经历过这一个旷野的时间。
And so in this time of wilderness, what is it meant to be for us?
在这种的旷野的时间，到底是有什么的意义呢？
Given a choice, we won't want to be in the wilderness, right?
如果有一个选择，你根本就不想要在这个旷野的时间，对吗？
So much better if we can be in a place where it's comfortable and relaxing and everything is provided for.
当然如果可以的话我们在一个舒适的地方那是最好的
But God in this time of reset
但是神在这个重新来过的一个时间
has helmed us into a season of wilderness
他是在不断的在建立我们在这个的旷野的季节里面
And as you know, the wilderness is mentioned throughout the Bible
这个旷野呢在圣经里面有很常被提到
And the Bible provides a biblical imagery of the wilderness. What is the image of wilderness for you and I?
圣经里面呢也有让我们看到就是大概的这一个的画面什么是旷野
It's a theme that every one of the believers have gone through.
是一个每一个信徒都会经历的
Adam and Eve
就像亚当夏娃
Cain was sent to the wilderness.
他们这该隐也是被派到这个的旷野
Moses had to flee Midian.
然后呢摩西
David had to run to the caves.
大卫呢需要跑到这个的山洞里。
John the Baptist in the New Testament.
施洗约翰在这个的新约里面有提到。
Is known to be the voice of the wilderness.
他也有提到这一个声音关于旷野的。
Daniel, can you turn on my slides, Daniel? Thank you. So this biblical imagery tells us this.
这个的圣经的这个画面呢，告诉我们这个事情。
All of their experiences from Adam to John，
全部在圣经里面的这些人物，由亚当到这个约翰。
It is an experience of dislocation, isolation, and deprivation。
会经历了很多的，就是一个人的这种的状况。
It's not an easy place to be。
不是一个简单的一个经历。
It's a place where sure there will be hardship。
我们也知道在这一种的状况当中一定有它的挑战
Jeremiah says that the wilderness is a barren land of desert
耶利米书呢说到这一种的旷野呢是在一种的 一片地
and Luke will say that it's a place of alienation and wandering
路加也有提到
and so when the Israelites had to go into the wilderness
当这一些以色列人要进到这个旷野的时候
It was going to, it makes it to them, they understood that there's no other way already.
他们都要知道就是已经没有其他的方式。
They had just gone through the miracle of the parting of the Red Sea.
他们经历的这一个的神迹就是被分红海。
There's no turning back.
没有能够回转的。
Can only go forward.
只能够向前去。
But here's the problem with the wilderness and the desert.
但是呢，这一个的旷野呢，就来到有一个问题
，no signpost，
没有一个的指导
，no pavement， no roads，
没有这一个的道路
，they had to completely rely on God，
他们需要全然的信靠神
，sound familiar to you and I？
是吗？很像很熟悉哦，对你和我
I don't know how you feel, but you know, when I went through MCO 1, I was quite happy lah.
你知道吗？当我经历第一次的这个 MCO 的时候，我是蛮开心的。
I get to work from home and be with my family, so I was quite happy.
我能够在家里面做工，也能够和我的家庭在一起，很开心。
MCO 2, well, what to do? Just have to bear with it, lor. This will pass.
第二次的 MCO 能怎样呢？我们还是要这样子的来经历嘛。
But MCO 3 came, and I was really quite frustrated.
当第三次的这个 MCO 的时候呢，我就有一点点的这一个不舒服。
How long more we have to go through this?
到底还要多久啊？我们要来经历这一切
？What is it going to be like looking ahead? You cannot even see a clear picture.
到底是什么呀？你根本前方都看不到一个的画面。
We have no choice but to rely on the leading of the Lord.
我们根本没有一个的选择，但是唯一的就是要信靠那全能神。
Just as the Israelites, when you can imagine, as you can imagine, they pass the parting of the Red Sea.
就很像这些以色列人，当他们过红海的时候。
And there's no choice but to trust God for what is ahead.
没有选择，但是他只能够相信神。
And in Deuteronomy 8:2,
在生命记八章二节
，it said that God's purpose is explained to them.
就有说到呢，这个神的这个旨意。
It says, "Remember how the Lord your God led you all the way in the desert those 40 years."
你们要纪念耶和华你的神在旷野引导你这四十年。
To humble you and test you,
是要苦练你、试炼你。
To know what is in your heart,
要知道你心内如何。
Whether or not you would keep His commands,
肯守他的诫命。
So there is a purpose.In the wilderness,
所以在旷野当中呢，仍然有神的旨意。
Which means this, there is a purpose for you and I to go through this season together.
所以呢，是你和我也有这个的旨意，要一起来经历这个的旷野。
We can't go back to how things were anymore.
我们没有办法回到以前的这个状况。
It has changed forever.
已经换了。
We have no choice but to move forward.
我们已经没有这个的选择，但是我们需要前进。
How to move forward? We need to look to God.
如何前进？我们需要来仰望神。
What do we need to do?
我们要如何抉择
？Individually or as a family, as a church, and nationally,
一个人、家庭，甚至是教会或者是国度。
We need to look to God.
我们需要仰望神。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, but you see, the desert in the Bible is not a hopeless place.
你看到呢，在圣经里面，这个旷野地方不是一个没有盼望的。
God uses the desert to speak to His beloved.
神使用这片的旷野呢，来对他所爱的子民说话。
God spoke to Abraham.
神对亚伯拉罕说话。
In the wilderness.
在也是在这个的旷野中
，God speaks to the Israelites.
神对以色列人说
，In the wilderness.
也是在这个旷野当中
，God spoke to Moses.
神对摩西说话
，In the wilderness.
也是在旷野中
，God spoke to Elijah.
神对以利亚说
，And many, many, many more.
还有很多很多
，In the wilderness.
也是在旷野中
，And of course, Jesus.
当然，耶稣。
Didn't just wander into the wilderness or the desert.
也是在这个旷野里面。
He wasn't lost for directions.
他没有失去这个的方向。
He was purposeful and intentional.
是故意的，而且是有意义的。
For him to go into the wilderness.
让他经历这一个的旷野。
And there he experienced that encounter with the Lord.
在那里他与神相遇。
There he would understand the purpose and hear from God.
在那里，他会明白那一个旨意，也聆听神的声音。
Every one of these men and women of God in the wilderness,
每一个神的仆人在这一个的旷野中
，experience miracles,
都会经历神迹。
So let's take comfort in knowing this,
让我们知道能够安心。
In the wilderness, God is present,
在这个旷野当中，神仍然存在。
And in the desert, He will make Himself known.
在一片的沙漠里面，神会让他的名字被得知。
My friends, can I assure you today?
朋友们，我今天要来向你来确信。
You are not alone.
你不是一个人。
I don't know you personally.
我可能不知道你一个。
I know some better than others.
可能我还知道一些还好过其他的。
I don't know what you're going through.
我不知道你所经历的是什么。
Sometimes I know a little bit through Facebook.
可能我知道了，通过那个的 Facebook。
Sometimes I know a little bit, you know, if I hear from others.
或者是我从别人的耳朵听到。
But I'm not in your shoes right now.
但是我现在不是在你的这一个的位置。
However, I can assure you this.
但是我能够给你一个确定。
You are not alone.
你不是一个人的。
Because God is with you.
因为神与你同在。
God is present.
神的同在。
He has a purpose.
他有一个
计划。And there is a plan.
而且他有一个计划。
There is a plan for you to succeed and to enter into his promise.
有一个计划让你能够成功，然后进入到他的这个应许。
But the wilderness actually is a beautiful place.
你知道吗？其实这一个的旷野地方呢，是一个很美好的地方。
To the naked eye, it looks very barren.
当然，透过我们的这个眼睛，可能看起来它是很荒凉。
It's definitely not an oasis.
当然它不是一个的绿洲。
It's not overflowing in abundance of resources.
它也不是很多的这个资源。
But when you look closely into the beauty of the wilderness,
但是当你来放大更靠近，看到这个旷野的美好。
Three very important things you will discover.
有三个很重要的东西你能够发现。
Next slide, please. There is a. You will discover God's miraculous provision.
你会来经历到神超乎的这一个的供应。
We just focus in on the Israelites and their experience.
所以我们要来看这个以色列人。
What happened? They were fed miraculously.
到底发生了什么事情？他们就是很神迹的，就是神这样子来。
I can't imagine manna and quail falling from the sky.
然后呢，我没有办法想到这些的玛纳从天上降下来。
When they were thirsty, water would gush out, flow from rocks.
当他们渴的时候，他们要做什么
？Incredible, miracles of even being able to defeat Amalekites in that condition.
他们能够这样子的来战胜这一切。
They were not left abandoned.
他们没有被遗弃。
They were always accompanied by the presence of God.
他们都是有神的同在陪伴他们度过。
Led by the pillar of cloud and fire.
他们背着这一个的火柱这样子的来带领。
Day and night, God assured them physically and visibly.
早晚呢，他们的这一个这都能够看见。
I am with you.
神就与他同在。
You are not alone.
你并不是一个人。
So my friends, whatever that you're going through in this season of your life,
朋友们，可能你这个季节所经历的这一切，
look very closely.
你要看清楚。
God is with you.
神与你同在。
He's with you day and night.
神早晚都与你同在。
And then you will find that the beauty of the wilderness is in the place of testing.
你会看到呢，就是这一种的美好的这个旷野呢，是透过一个被试炼的地方。
Turn with me to Numbers chapter 9, verse 18 to 22.
我们要翻去这个的民数记九章十八到二十二节。
And let's just read a little bit about the Israelites and their experience.
我们要来读一点点关于这个以色列人的经历。
I read first, then you read. Okay. So at the Lord's command, the Israelites set out.At his command, they encamped. As long as the cloud stayed over the tabernacle, they remained in camp. When the cloud remained over the tabernacle a long time, the Israelites obeyed the Lord's order and did not set out. Sometimes the cloud was over the tabernacle only a few days. At the Lord's command, they would encamp, and then at his command, they would set out. Sometimes the cloud stayed only from evening till morning, and when it lifted in the morning, they set out.Whether by day or by night, whenever the cloud lifted, they set out. Whether the cloud stayed over the tabernacle for 2 days or a month or a year, the Israelites would remain in camp and not set out. But when it lifted, they would set out.
以色列人遵耶和华的吩咐起行，也遵耶和华的吩咐安营。云彩在帐幕上停住几时，他们就住营几时。云彩在帐幕上停留许多日子，以色列人就守耶和华所吩咐的步起行。有时云彩在帐幕上几天，他们就照耶和华的吩咐住营，也照耶和华的吩咐起行。有时从早上到早晨，在有这一个的云彩在帐幕上，早晨云彩收上去，他们就起行。 有时昼夜云彩停在帐幕上，搜去的时候他们就起行，云彩停留在帐幕上，无论是两天是一月是一年，以色列人就驻营不起行，但云彩搜上去他们就起行。
Can you imagine the amount of uncertainty in their lives?
你可以明白就是他们很多的不确定在他们的生命里面吗？
You know, when we travel, at least we know the schedule, right?
当我们要来就是去旅游的时候，我们都知道这个的行程嘛。
You have to schedule your flight.
我们知道我们几点要起飞。
Or you have to plan for your Grab to arrive.
可能你需要来安排这个的车来载你。
You have to kind of, you know, estimate how long the journey would be.
你需要来策划大概要多久的时间。
What's going to be your arrival time?
你几点呢要抵达这个地方。
But life is completely stripped of that in the wilderness.
但是呢，在这个旷野里面，根本就没有在这一个的计划里面。
It meant being ready at any time to move when God moves.
这个呢，就是要时刻预备，当神动的时候，你就要动。
What's it been like for you these past 2 years?
这两年就是像给你是一个什么样的意义呢
？Have you been feeling lost and unsure where to go?
你会觉得很像迷失了，不知道要去哪里吗？
Have you just kept yourself busy doing the day-to-day, hoping that somehow things would just pass?
你是否让自己就是很忙碌，然后呢，希望一天一天这样子就过去？
Or are you actively keeping your eye on the cloud?
还是呢，你很一直的把你的眼目放在这一个的云端上？
And at any time, be ready.
时刻就是预备好。
God moves, you go.
神动你也去。
God moves, you follow.
神动你也跟随。
And that's what they had to do, the Israelites.
这个就是以色列人所做的事。
It could be 2 days, 2 months.
可能是两天两个月。
It could be 2 years.
可能是两年。
But they had always to be ready to move when the cloud moves.
但是他们时刻都预备好了，当这个云一动的时候，他们也要动。
I can't predict for sure what's going to happen in the days to come.
我可能不能预测接下来这个日子要发生什么事情。
But I do believe this, that you and I need to be ready.
但是我相信的是，你和我都要预备好自己。
That God is moving.
神在动。
And when God is moving, we can't be laid back.
当神在动的时候，我们不能够这样子的来停留。
And when God is moving, we have to be ready to respond.
当神在动的时候，我们要预备好自己来回应。
And so we want to be able to follow God and work through this place of testing.
我们要能够来跟随神，经过这个的试炼。
And when they went through this place of testing,
当我们经历这一个的地方的时候，
there was always the assurance that you will receive the promise.
就会有很多的确定，就是你会得到这一个的应许。
It's not an easy thing to go through.
不是一个简单的事情，当你经历的时候。
No one can define for you how long that testing will be.
没有人能够告诉你，你在这个试炼当中会多久。
However, if we are able to fully trust in the Lord,
但是当你能够全然的来信靠神的时候
，It may not be as bad as you think.
它不会比你想象的这么糟糕。
In fact, you might discover that it's even more amazing.
可能你会来发现是很美好的一件事情。
Because you dare to let go of your expectations,
因为你愿意的放下你一切所期望的
，and fully go after what God has in store for you.
全然的跟随神所为你预备的。
So in the place of testing,
所以在这种试炼的地方
where faith is stretched,
这一个就是信心被扩张的一个地方。
Faith has to be stretched,
信心需要被扩张
so that we can grow in our faith.
所以我们在这个信心里面才能成长。
If life was always so comfortable,
如果生命永远都这么的舒适
our faith would not be stretched.
我们的信心根本就不会被扩张。
As ministers and as leaders in the church,
身为侍奉领导者，在教会
，faith needs to stretch，
信心需要被扩张
，capacity needs to grow，
这一个的容量需要被扩张。
Otherwise, instead of becoming one that would accelerate the growth of others，
不然呢，我们要成为一个这样子来去启动的
，we will become a limitation，
我们可能会成为一个限制了。
By the way, I'm also a mother，
我也是一个母亲，一位母亲。
I have 2 teenage children。
我有两个年轻的孩子。
哎呦，冰山呐、
啊，就是会晕。
哎呦 ，I said, when you have teenage children, right? You wish they were baby, you know.
有时候当他们来到这个阶段的时候，你会希望他是一个婴儿。
When they are baby, they don't talk back to you.
因为当他是婴儿的时候，他不会向你来回应。
My son is 13 years old.
我的儿子呢13岁。
I say, wow, can be lawyer, are you?
我说话，你可以成为律师了。
Very good at answering and giving, and discussing back his reasons.
就是很厉害的，能够来回答这一个的他的这一些的理由。
But through my children, I understand how faith has to grow.
但是对于我的孩子，我明白信心需要成长。
To the encounter and the testing as a mother.
你知道吗？身为一个母亲的这种的试炼。
I have really seen God at work.
我看清楚神在当中动工。
Wait until you become a parent.
等到你们成为一位的父母亲。
Then you will understand what I'm talking about.
你就会明白我在讲的是什么。
There was a season of time my daughter, right, really struggled with her studies.
在一个的季节呢，就是我的女儿挣扎于她的学业。
I'm so shy to tell you I cannot sleep, you know.
就是我很害羞的告诉你，就是其实我没有办法睡着。
She went to a tough school.
她去了这一个的学校。
They make the exam very hard, man.
就是那一切的考试呢都很难。
So to fail is very normal.
所以呢，当她拿到这个 fail 的时候，是很普遍的一个事情。
So from one, from two, from three, every time come back are all 红色的。
初一、初二、初三，他回来的全部都是红色的。
Then, as a mother, I said, "Ayo, how lah like this? How to go to college?"
所以，身为一个妈妈呢，就看到这个成绩单，就是怎么办呢？怎样的去到这个大学
？How to help her? Because we sent her international school.
怎样来帮她呢？因为我们就是把她带到这个国际学校。
So primary school is Chinese school.
在这个小学呢，就是这个华校。
我不可以讲华语啊。
I cannot speak English.
Chinese.
Chinese.
My children can speak Chinese.
我的孩子可以说中文。
Mommy, how to do? Don't know.
So my 当我的这个孩子来问我的时候，我不会。
My son go tuition. Okay.
所以我就把他派到去这一个的补习班。
That's primary school. That's fine. And then go secondary school. God provided, so we can send her to international school.
来到中学的时候呢，神供应，所以我们能够把他送去这个国际学校。
全部英文啊。
很好，很不错。
All in English, right?
Yeah, 全部在英文。
I still cannot help.
但是我还是帮不了。
Because the system changed already.
因为整个的这个系统呢已经改变了。
So the IGCSE UK system is different from our Malaysian syllabus.
他们的那种的系统跟我们马来西亚的这个系统是不一样的。
Mommy, how to do the maths?
怎样来做这个数学题？
I don't know.
我也不会。
哎呀 ，Go international school also must find tuition.
哎呀，去到这个国际学校还是要来找这个补习班。
Now my primary school can go tuition center.
可能就是小学的时候也是要去补习班。
Consider 便宜哦哈。
比较便宜。
Consider cheaper. Go secondary school because IGCSE have to do one-on-one tuition.
就是因为它是国际学校，所以需要给这个一对一的这个补习班。
But I want to share with you how good God is.
不过我要来和你分享神有多么的好。
My daughter just finished her IGCSE exam.
我女儿呢刚就是完成她的这个考试。
That means the Form 5 exam 啦。
就是我们的这个初五中五的这一个的考试。
So remember Form 1, Form 2, Form 3, right? All 红色红色红色 right?
就是初一到初三呢，它都是这一个的全部都是满江红。
And I look back every time we had a need, God would provide.
但是呢，当我每次看回去的时候，当有一个需要，神都一定会供应。
She had a maths tuition teacher who is a Christian lady.
她有一个数学补习老师呢，她是一个基督徒。
So when she knows that I'm a pastor, she gives us 50% discount.
所以当她知道我是牧师的时候呢，她就给我们这个50%的折扣。
And then last minute, right? Because after trial exam,
就是最后的这一个分钟。
I can see that her English need a bit of like push, a bit more help for her English.
然后呢，我看到她的英文需要有更多的这个的补足。
My English so good, also cannot help 嘛。
我的英文也不好，也不能够帮啊。
So then God also provide an English tutor.
所以呢，神也预备了这个英文的老师。
Also a Christian lady.
也是一个的基督徒。
Who gave us also 50% discount.
也是给了我们50%的折扣。
So I was so amazed, you know.
所以我很就是高兴。
I said, God, you know, when we don't know what to do, you are so faithful to provide for our every need.
当我们不知道要怎么做的时候呢，神还是这样子来供应。
I want to encourage you. There's going to be seasons in your life you really don't know what to do.
我要来鼓励你，就是可能有一些季节你是真的不知道要怎么做。
Because it's a testing of your faith.
因为这个是试炼你信心的这一个的时刻。
But God is with you.
但是神与你同在。
He will provide a way. He will provide a way.
啊，就是。
He will make a way.
哦，他会开道路。
And so my daughter got her exam results last month.
所以呢，我的女儿上个月就拿到这个的成绩。
Sorry, this month 18 of January.
就是这个月18号。
All glory to God, 啊。
荣耀归给神。
It is.
就是八个 A.
Glory to God.
荣耀归给神。
Nothing to do with me.
跟我是没有这一个的
I couldn't help my daughter.
我根本就帮不了我的女儿。
But when I reflect.On this experience, this time of testing.
但是当我来思考这一个被试炼的过程
Once again, I can stand here and say, God is so gracious.
我还是能够站立跟你说，神真的是很好。
He didn't set you up for failure.
他没有来设立你就是要经历这个失败。
He set you up for success.
他建立你是因为你要成功。
And he didn't just set you up for success as an individual.
他让你允许经历这一切，不是一个人的。
Come on, friends, he set you up for success generations upon generations upon generations.
这个是要传到下一代跟下下一代的。
Come on, let's give God the glory.
我们要给荣耀归给神。
So we don't need to be afraid of this wilderness.
所以我们不需要在这个旷野的时刻呢感到惧怕。
God is on the move.
神还是会动。
And he has a plan.
他有一个计划。
I think one of the most beautiful things that we can appreciate of the wilderness is the presence of God.
另外一个我们可以真正来感谢的就是神的同在。
Because in the wilderness is where God begins to strip away your comforts and strip away what you're familiar with and take away the distractions.
因为在旷野的时候呢，神要来拆毁你一切的舒适，而且拿去一切拦阻你的。
And it becomes a place where you encounter His presence.
就是一个地方你能够与他的同在相遇。
So Exodus talks about how Moses, when he met with the Lord in the tabernacle.
出埃及记呢就说到摩西如何在这个的帐幕里面与神相遇。
When the cloud would settle on the tent.
当这个云在这个的帐幕的时候。
There the glory of God can be seen.
神的荣耀就彰显了。
So in this place of wilderness,
在这一个的旷野当中
God wants to show you His glory.
神要你让你看见他的荣耀。
Yes, there's a lot of uncertainty.
可能会有很多的不确定。
We may not have the answers.
我们可能还没有这个的答案。
But in His presence, when we are found,
但是在他的同在里的时候
God will show you His glory.
神会让你看见他的荣耀。
So Tripp Prince, who is a author, a Christian author,
有这一个的基督徒的这一个作家呢
says this, that the wilderness seasons bring with them testings and challenge, but it's in this place of desperation that God meets our deepest needs.
在这个旷野的这个季节里面呢，神带了这个试炼跟挑战给他们，但也就是在这种的地方，他们非常的需要神。
Life as we know it has changed completely.
就是整个的生命呢，需要的有一个改变。
But no matter how tough, no matter how challenging,
无论有多难、多挑战
at that place of desperation, God will meet your needs.
在那一种极力需求的时候，神一定会遇到你的需求。
You will not just have enough.
你不会只是这样子的足够。
You will have more than enough. Amen.
你会有多有余出来。
Hallelujah. So I want to share with you how you can brave through the wilderness.
我要来告诉你，你可以怎样的度过这个的旷野。
And before I go into some of the key things about braving through the wilderness,
当我还没有进入这个的要点的时候。
I want to share a little bit more about the experience for the past 1 year.
我要来跟你分享多一点这一年里面所经历的。
For in total of 5 years prior to 2021,
在五年里面一直到2021年
，God has been preparing me for the next phase of ministry.
神一直都在装备我要去到另外一个阶段。
At that point in 2016, I was in Taiwan.
2016年呢，我在台湾。
And so I was assisting with a national youth camp in Taiwan.
我在和这一个台湾的这一个的青少地方有帮忙。
The camp was for 3 days.
那一个的营会呢是两天的时间。
And God began to speak to me every day, said one thing.
神每一天呢都对我说话。
So first day he said to me, Karen, do you want to step out of the boat?
他就问我说，Karen, 你要不要来踏出这个的船？
I mean, Karen, you want to walk on water, sorry.
Karen, 你要不要就是走在这个的水上？
He said, if you want to walk on water, you got to step out of the boat.
他说，如果你要走在这个水面的时候，你可以踏出这个船。
Okay lah, easy.
我说，可以啦，容易。
Of course, I want to have that kind of walk on water experience.
我也当然想要有这样的经历啊。
God, if you allow me to experience it, of course I want it.
神，如果你允许的话，当然我要。
Second day.
第二天。
Then he said, Karen,
他就跟我说 ，Karen,
would you give up your salary?
你会不会愿意的来放弃你的这一个的钱收入？
我说哈 ，give up my salary 呀、
啊？我说哈，你要这样子让我放弃我的这一个收入
？So at that point in time, I worked in church 15 years.
在那个时候呢，我已经在教会做工15年了。
It took me 15 years to reach the salary that I gave up when I joined the ministry.
15年的时间呢，一直到我参与另外一个事工，就是我需要放弃的。
Not 15 months 啊，
不是15个月。
15 years 啊，
15年。
哇 ，15 years， then now only you ask me give up salary， is it？
15年了，你才告诉我要来放弃这一切收入是吗
？Now I'm a little bit more comfortable。
我现在已经有开始舒服的状况。
And you asking me to give it up again？
你要我来放弃这一切
？This one I need to think。
Wait, 这个我真的要来想一想
think first.
让我想
But I said, you know, God, all these years in the ministry, 15 years, right?
在这一个15年的这个事工里面
Take pay cut 啦，什么什么啦 sacrifice and everything
yes, 就是有很多的这些的牺牲
I never lacked one day
没有一天我是缺乏的
Never
从来没有
I never lacked at all.
没有一次我是缺乏的。
In 15 years.
在15年里面。
So I said, okay, I can.
那我说可以。
You want me to start over again?
你要我重新来过。
I will do it.
我会。
I will trust you.
我会来相信你。
If you can provide for me these 15 years.
如果这15年里面你能供应我。
Then the rest of my life, I'm very sure you will take care of me.
我相信呢，十五年里面你能供应我其余的，你一样会来照顾我。
Day three，
第二天
，I see myself on the pulpit of glad tidings。
我看到我呢，就是我在这个的高端。
Now， my church， I love my church， I have served that church。I was saved in glad tidings， and I have served from the day I became a minister， I served in glad tidings。
我在 glad tidings 呢被得救，也是在那里侍奉。
So to earn。The privilege to minister in the main service is not something so easy.
能够有这个机会呢，就是在大会这样子的来。
You understand what I mean?
不是容易。
You need some experience. You need to, you know, the pastor need to know that he has confidence that I can handle the word of God and minister appropriately.
你需要有一点的经验，然后牧师呢也需要对你有这个的信心。
So I saw myself on the pulpit of glad tidings.
我看到我自己呢，就是在这个 glad tidings 的顶端。
And then God said to me, Karen, are you ready to come down?
神就问我，你愿不愿意的踏下来？
哇 ，not easy 哦 ，because to earn the I call it recognition 呐、哈 ，recognition because in the end also is not something that is just freely easily given away. I had to earn that recognition.
是不容易的，因为你要得到这个被肯定跟认定。
It took many years for me to be recognized officially as a pastor due to the process of things.
需要经历很多年很多的过程。
And so to get to where I was, and also have at that time, I was already the head of a creative ministry.So Easter, Christmas, Father Day, Mother Day, all the main events, right? I'm the one that do all the planning and all the mobilization.
一直以来都是我来策划很多的这些的event 跟行程。
Yeah, so it took many years to build the ministry.
花了很长的时间来建立这一切的事工。
And when God said, "Karen, are you ready to come down?" It felt like He was saying, "You need to let go of all this and start over again."
当神说你要下来的时候，就感觉你需要放开一切，重新来过。
Would you do that?
你愿意吗？
哇、wow, ，That was very very tough for me to say yes to.
对我来讲，不容易。
Because we're talking about one third of my life that I had given to serve the Lord, and then here you're saying lay it all down and start over.
因为呢，在这里你就跟我说要放下一切，要重新来过。
And at that point in time, I don't know what God had in mind for me.
在那个时刻，我不知道神给我有什么样的一个方向。
But I trusted the Lord.
但是呢，我相信神。
And at the altar at the camp in Taiwan,
就是在那个台湾的这个营会
，I said yes, God.
我说好的，神。
I will give up position, I will give up title, I will give up the pulpit.
我会完全所有都放下
，to follow you.
要跟随你。
And so it was fast forward 5 years later.
五年后呢
，that I begin to see God bring this vision to pass.
然后呢，我就看到神将这个的意象带过。
So today I stand before you, I am back in the marketplace.
我今天呢站在你的面前，我又再次的回到这个职场侍奉。
I stepped down as a full-time staff of Glad Tidings in December 2020.
在这个的12月2020的时候，我就从这一个的全职侍奉放下。
First of January 2021.
在这个1月1号2021年
I come out entirely on my own.
我完全再次的出来。
So that means no more salary 啦。
已经是完全没有这一个的收入。
I have some savings.
我有一点的储蓄。
And I have an understanding with my husband.
我也有得到我老公的这一个的明白。
So I asked my husband give me 1 year.
我跟我老公说要给我一年的时间。
You help me to tie over for 1 year.
你帮助我能够这样子的一年
，and then I should be okay.
然后我就应该没问题了。
But I want to share with you very gratefully.
我要很感恩来跟你分享
，that God has provided miraculously.
神呢就是很神奇的这样子来供应。
He's provided to the point that my car is paid off. No more loan.
他供应到就连我的车，我根本就没有剩下的这个还债。
He's provided to the point that I actually amazingly have more savings than when I was earning a monthly salary.
他供应我到我所存的跟我之前所赚的还要多。
Only God can do that.
只有神才能做这个事情。
And so last year, end of last year, Pastor Victor, Pastor May, and I, we got in touch.
就是去年的时候呢，我跟 Pastor May 跟 Pastor Victor 有这个的连接。
And we have been just talking about some opportunities to serve the students of BCM.
然后我们就说到要如何的能够和这个 BCM 的学生来侍奉。
And in my heart, I said, God, I want to bless the students of BCM.
在我的心中啊，我就说我要成为 BCM 学生的这个祝福。
And I want to trust you for provision.
我要相信你的供应。
That whatever that I need, the marketplace will provide.
无论我去到哪里呢，这一个的职场侍奉那边呢会供应。
And I can serve the students of BCM without any worry or concern about finances.
然后呢，不需要担忧这个金钱，我还是能够来侍奉 BCM 的学生。
This morning,
今早
I just signed a contract.
我就签约了
for the next 6 months.
给另外六个月
that will provide for me for the whole year.
他会供应我一整年。
Come on, let's give God the glory.
来给神这个的荣耀。
God is at work.
神在动工。
God is moving.
神在动。
Are you ready to follow?
你预备好要跟随了吗
？So I can only challenge you and encourage you 5 things.
我来这样子的来给你这个挑战。
Daniel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
五样事情。
Trust in the Lord.
信靠神。
To break through the wilderness, you need to trust Him.
你要经历这一个的旷野呢，你需要完全的信靠神。
You don't have compass, you don't have direction, you don't have the resources. Trust God.
你没有方向，你没有资源，但是你要信靠神。
Because, like I said just now, God did not set you up to fail.
我跟你说了，神他没有这样子放你在一个地方，但是你要信靠他。
God did not call you to full-time ministry so that you will fail.
神没有叫你来到这个全职侍奉，所以你能够失败。
Trust him.
你要信靠他。
He has a good plan for your life.
他在你的这个生命有美好计划。
To bless you.
他有一个计划要祝福你。
To give you a future and a hope.
给你一个盼望，一个未来。
And that trust has to come with submission.
这个的信靠呢，要有这一个的降服。
Submitting to God even when you don't agree.
你要降服于神，即使你不认同。
I have children, so I know the generation after us have different thinking.
我明白呢，因为我是一个父母，所以就是另外一个有不同的想法。
Different point of views.
有不同的看见。
You're not wrong.
你没有错。
I'm not wrong either.
我也没有错。
But it takes us to submit to what God wants.
但是我们需要来降服，就是顺服。
Submission is greater than obedience.
这一种的降服呢，是大过于顺服。
Submit even when you don't understand.
你需要这样子的来为教顺服，即使你不明白。
And in this wilderness journey.
在这种的旷野的这个旅程
，You can't be heavy loaded with things and baggages.
你不能够带着很多的这个的重担。
You need to consciously unload that baggage.
你需要很刻意的来放下这一切。
Last year when I stepped out, it was not an easy time personally either.
去年呢，当我来踏出来的时候呢，对于我来讲不简单。
But it's not going to be good for me to enter through that season of wilderness with a lot of baggage.
但是呢，也是不是一件好事。当我能够要把这一切的重担带着进去
，I had to work on unloading that baggage.
我需要做刻意的，就是放下这一切包袱。
Every day I would be so scared, fearful.
每一天我都会很惧怕。
What's going to happen, God? I stepped out.
我已经踏出了这个地方，到底会发生什么事？到底什么才是对的
？Did I hear you correctly?
我有听到你要来再改正吗
？I have to keep unloading my fears.
我需要一直的这样子放下我的恐惧。
I have to keep unloading my uncertainty.
我需要一直放下这一些的未确定。
I have to keep, you know, working through the scarcity mentality.
我需要这样子刻意性的来保守我的这个意念。
Like that's all I have. I cannot part with this. This is all I have. It's a scarcity mentality.
这就是我所有的缺乏的相思。
And so I have to unload that to God daily.
我需要这样子的故意的来交给神。
What about you?
你呢
？I don't know where you are in this journey of wilderness.
我不知道你在这个的旷野这个旅程当中的哪一个阶段。
You could be just going into a wilderness season.
你可能现在才要开始的进入。
Or in the middle of it.
可能在中间
or towards the end,
可能已经要结束了
or you have come out of the wilderness season,
可能已经从这个旷野的季节出来了
and already experiencing a promise from God,
然后你可能已经正在经历神的应许
whichever part of the journey you are in,
无论你在哪一个阶段
this applies, all this applies,
就是每一个这一个都是有用
you still need to trust God,
你还需要来信靠神
you got to submit to him,
你还需要来顺服他
you need to unload your baggages so that you can remain focused,
你还需要放下一切的包袱所以你才能够继续的来专注
stay focused on what?
你需要专注于神
stay focused on the cloud,
你需要专注于这个的云
you got to keep your eye on the cloud,
你要放你的眼目在这个的云
because when the cloud moves, you move,
因为当这个云动的时候你也要跟着动
but the cloud doesn't move, then you stay,
云没有动，你就要停留。
And you stay focused.
而且你要一专注。
Align your will with God's will.
对齐你的这个旨意与神的旨意。
You can't have God's way and your way.
不可以有神的这个方向和你的方向。
It's the way of the cross.
而是这个神的方式。
And you can ask any of the pastors here, and they will tell you that it gets more and more challenging.
你可以问任何一个的牧者呢，就是他会越来越挑战。
Dying to yourself is not an easy path to take.
要死去自己呢，这一个的过程是不容易的。
But it's going to release miracles upon miracles in your life.
但是他会放很多的这个神迹在你的生命。
So align your will with God's will.
对齐你的这个旨意与神的旨意。
And that would mean some of us have to struggle.
有一些人呢会有这个的挣扎
Some of us have to surrender
有一些需要全然的降服交托。
Some of us just have to fully submit.
有一些需要全部的顺服。
And follow God's way.
然后跟随神的道路。
And through all that, stay anchored.
无论如何呢，你需要继续的有这个的扎根。
Stay anchored in your faith and hope in the Lord.
扎根你的这个的信心在神那里。
The wilderness is a place where you will be stripped of everything.
这个的旷野的这个季节，就是你会完全的没有一切。
All that you know, all that you have, everything will be stripped away.
所有你懂的，所有你有的，都需要完全的被拆掉。
All that will be left.
所有剩下的
is dependency on God and His sufficiency.
只有信靠神和他的供应。
God is more than enough for you.
神是足够你的。
Amen.
Amen.
Can I invite the worship team to come back up?
我要欢迎这个的敬拜团。
And maybe our brother can just play the piano for a short while. And I'm going to challenge you as we close today.
在这个结束的时候呢
to take a moment of reflection.
你要来反思。
So this, we started this morning by having you think about the last 2 years.
今早呢，我就来问你们关于这一个两年的所发生的事。
And at this point,
但是在这个的时候
I'd like to challenge you to think about what's ahead in 2022.
我要来让你反思，就是在2022年所开始的这一个是什么。
In whatever.Journey, wherever you are in the journey of the wilderness,
无论如何你在哪一个的阶段
Today my question is this.
我的问题就是
What are 3 actions that God is calling you to do?
神叫你做的三个举动是什么呢
So right where you are, you can write it on your notebook, you can write it on your phone, your digital devices. Just begin to spend a little bit of time with the Lord.
花时间和神，然后你可以写下、记录下来。
And ask the Lord in the year 2022.
问神在2022年
，What are the 3 actions you're calling me to do?
神要你做的是什么
？Let's take this time.
花这个时间。
Thank you, Jesus.